This is, we're a Wurrung country, and we pay our respect to the past elders and the future generation of elders. Let me introduce ourselves. This is Tina, and she's a psychologist. She's still registered as a psychologist, and she only stopped working as a psychologist 2 months ago. Anyway, myself, I'm actually Indigenous Australian, Indigenous Australian, Aboriginal. My country, I'm from Victoria, so my family's country is Shepparton, Bendigo, Ballarat, all the way down to Maryborough in Victoria, and I'm a traditional owner of the Bendigo State Forest. So that's my country. I am original Australian, and I'm a registered social worker. So Tina's a psychologist, I'm a social worker, and these classes, we try to make them like art therapy. By the time you leave here today, you will feel so relaxed, happy. You'll find this very enjoyable and fun. You'll leave here very relaxed. All the stress will be gone. Anyway, there's two things that I need you to do first. I'm going to give you a 1 hour speech. And during that 1 hour speech, I'm going to explain to you everything there is to know about resin and resin art. Three things first before we start. And the first thing is, come to the front and choose a board. Everyone needs to choose a board. We have serving tray boards, we have little tables with legs, we have coffee table boards. So come to the front and choose a board. Now that was the first thing. The second thing we want you to do is, you've all got some painter's tape and a black Nikko pen in front of you. So you tear up a bit of painter's tape about this big and put it on the back of your board, and then write your name on it. Now the next thing we want you to do is, when you do resin art paintings, resin likes to flow. It loves to flow. And it likes to go flat, even. So when you do your painting on the board, the resin will flow a bit. It'll flow that way over the board. Now I love the resin going over the side. It looks beautiful on the paintings. Resin will also go underneath the board. And then tomorrow when you come and pick up your painting, you have hard resin drops all here around the outside underneath your board. So the next thing we want you to do is get some of this painter's tape and you just put it around the outside of the board. So tomorrow when you come correct your painting, the resin will have dried on this and you just peel it off. So get the painter's tape and you put it around the outside of the underneath of your board. If you've got a board, you put three plastic containers like that, and you put your board on top of it, like that. If you have a canvas, you put four plastic containers just under the corners of the canvas, just under the corners of the canvas like that. So put the plastic containers, three under boards and four under canvases, just to lift the board up off the table. Otherwise, the resin will drip over the board, and tomorrow morning when you come, the board will be stuck to the tablecloth. Once you've done that, you'll find a thick paintbrush like this on your table, and you'll find four tubes of a different coloured acrylic paint. So everybody grab the thick paintbrush, and you'll see four tubes of paint in front of you. They're different colours, and guess what? The colours don't matter at all. You can choose any colour you want. It doesn't matter what colour you choose. Because what we're going to do is paint your board with the acrylic paint. And while I'm talking for almost an hour, it will dry while I'm talking. That's why we're putting it on the board first, because when it dries, resin loves to stick to it. And you won't see this under because your resume upgrading is going to go over top. So whatever color you choose doesn't matter because your resume painting is going over top of this and you won't see the paint when you're finished. It's just because resin likes to stick to acrylic paint.
How do you wash our brushes once they've got paint on?
Tina, you get a
bucket of water.
Tina, yeah, you fill this up with water.
You might notice the room is about 20 degrees. We try to keep the room between 20 and 26 degrees because resin art is best done in a cool room. If the room was too hot, your painting would be spoiled. It wouldn't turn out as good. So while you do resin art, the room should be in a cool temperature. If it's summer, put the aircon on. Because when you do resin art, it should be done in a cool temperature between 20 and 26 degrees. Okay. Now, they should dry within the next 20 minutes. You'll notice you have a pair of gloves on the table. You can put them on whenever you want. It does get sticky and messy. You will get resin on your fingers. And if you get resin on your fingers, you'll be scrubbing your fingers for a month to get the resin off. That's why the first thing is you always wear rubber gloves. If you need to go to the bathroom, take the gloves off, put them in the bin, and when you come back from the bathroom, put a different pair of gloves on. We've got more gloves to give you if you run out of gloves. Always have gloves on. And we have some safety rules. The first safety rule is, while you're using resin, you are guaranteed to get on your fingers. You will get on your fingers. Never touch your body, don't touch your clothing, and never ever touch your face, especially your eyes, nose, and mouth. Do not touch your face when you're doing resin art. With resin, you can make whatever you want. There's serving trays, there's boards. We hang ours on the wall at home. There's coffee tables, you can put legs on the coffee tables. We have coffee tables at home, absolutely beautiful coffee tables. You can make jewelry. Resin is the strongest glue in the world. It's the strongest glue in the world. When you use alumite, it comes in two tubes, part A and part B, and when you squeeze it, it goes together and it's a very strong glue. On your table, you have part A and part B. It's the same. When you mix these together, it becomes the strongest glue in the world. Resin sticks to a lot of things. It usually doesn't stick to plastic. It will stick to some plastics, but it doesn't usually stick to plastic. When the resin drips off your board onto the tablecloth, and you come to get your painting tomorrow, you can actually peel that resin off the tablecloth and go home and cut it in shapes. Resin likes sticking to wood, cardboard. It doesn't stick to plastic or metal. It doesn't stick to painter's tape. If you put masking tape on, it will stick to masking tape, but it doesn't stick to painter's tape. Resin, like I told you before, it loves flowing. It loves moving. Always trying to make itself flatter and flatter. It'll drip over the sides of your board. It'll make the sides of your board beautiful. It'll drip onto the tablecloth. You can peel it off tomorrow morning, cut it in shapes. Resin has been used in Australia for the last 80,000 years. Aboriginals have been using resin for thousands and thousands of years. What they would do is get spinifex, and at the top of spinifex is that black flowery stuff. They would shake the spinifex to make that fall off the spinifex. They would put it in the fire and melt it. And it was resin. When they melted it in the fire, it was liquid resin. Then they would use it as a very strong glue to make their spears and other tools. So Aboriginal people in Australia have been using resin for thousands and thousands of years. But in the Western world, resin was invented in 1907 by a Belgian American in Europe. He invented resin using chemicals. Now the resin he invented is toxic. It's made from chemicals. It's a toxic resin. However, that resin is still used today to make plastic chairs. The resin we have given you, it's not toxic, it's non-toxic, it's food safe, it's organic, it's very, very safe resin. It's also very, very expensive prison.
Oh. It's making faster, but it's not doing it how we want it, is it?
No.
We're going to have to make more white for you. We're going to have to make more white. So here's the secret. I've just put all the bottle of A in, all the bottle of B in, but here's the secret. This is also B. And if you just put a little bit more B in, just a little bit, the B is what makes it dry. So this will actually dry faster overnight.
Guess what, there's one more trick. You can also tilt your board to make it flow. Yeah. Tilt your board, use your blower machine. I want you to be happy with it before you leave. Guess what? You're up to this stage. Here's clear resin that I've made. And with the clear resin, just very lightly, just cover everything with clear resin. See how much resin there is? You want that to go right across everything. Very light. I like coating the resin over top of everything.
Wow!
Lots and lots of shells.
I like
just coat, that, coat everything with the resin. Coat the whole, everything with the resin. And then if you want more white froth in here, we can make more white froth. See here, if you want more white froth there, we can make more white and put more white froth on. It's not too late. It's not too late until the painting's dry. That's not until tomorrow morning. So if you want to change it, we can change it. We can put more white there. We can do, if you're not happy with it, we'll just change it.
No, I'm happy with that.
Are you happy? Does it look like it, what you wanted?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that looks good. And that clear coat of resin you just put all over top, it will dry like glass tomorrow morning. When you touch it, it'll be like touching glass.